Thank you for making the time to be a part of this really exciting announcement.
It's great to be dealing with Bayer because they have a level of expertise in this area that not many other companies in the world do.
Well, it's very exciting, this agreement with GRDC.
And it gives us a chance really to work closer with Australia and tailor weed control solution for the Australian grower.
This is a creative interaction between GRDC and Bayer.
We need to partner with these multinational companies to get a greater value from our research dollar.
What do we get? And of course it's a royalty stream, it's ownership of some of the IP. That works, and so let's do business.
John, today you've announced a major cooperative investment with Bayer. What's at the heart of that?
As growers around Australia know, one of the biggest costs that growers have is controlling weeds. In fact, weeds cost Australian growers about $3 billion every single year.
We know there's significant financial returns to those who own the IP on new molecules. How's that built into this agreement?
Well, the reason why we're investing is so that we can provide growers with another tool to control weeds, to provide them with a new herbicide. That's the reason why we're investing. However, there will be potential success fees and royalties that would flow to GRDC, which then allows us to reinvest that on the behalf of growers in other research and development.
How confident are you in the cost benefit?
If you look back to the 1990s, we had a lot of private sector companies involved in developing new herbicides. Mm. And there was on average globally about 250 patents being registered every single year. Currently it's less than 50. And it's critical now as we get glyphosate resistance that we actually have some more options. So the benefit of having a new herbicide in the armoury of growers couldn't be higher than what it is currently.
What will it take to make this look like a great decision?
If you look back over the last 20 years, we haven't had a new mode of action discovered. And even if you look at what we've currently got in the pipeline, if you look at the time it takes to get to market, we can pretty confidently predict there won't be a new mode of action in the next 8 years. What we're aiming with this project is to make sure we do have a new mode of action or a new herbicide in the period 10 to 15 year time. So it is a longer term investment. We invest in short-term projects that give immediate benefit. We invest in medium-term projects, 5 to 8 years. Things like agronomy and soils. But this is what we call one of our more strategic investments. It's not going to deliver in the next 8 years. It's in that 10 to 15 year period, but we have to have those things ready for our growers in that time frame.
If I walk into that building in Germany where all of this activity is now about to play out, say in a year's time, what will I see there? What will be happening on our behalf as a result of this investment?
So they'll be using Australian weeds in those tests. So when you look at their glasshouses, when you look at their growth tablets, they'll have Australian weeds sitting in there. And we'll be seeing the activity of those new molecules on Australian weeds. And then the very next step will be they'll be tested in Australia under Australian conditions. So the chances of finding a new herbicide which is going to be effective for the Australian environment is much, much higher than it currently is, where most of the testing is done on US weeds and most of the testing is then done in the paddock in the USA.
How does it shift Bayer's focus in Australia's direction in terms of its R&D in this area?
It puts a much stronger focus on Australia as a priority region, as a tier one country, and a much stronger focus on selecting for activity against Australian weeds. And they already do have a large footprint here in Australia. They've made a big investment in a research facility at Horsham, and no doubt some of the early testing will actually happen there in Horsham.
This deal's been a couple of years in the making. How satisfying is it to get it to this point?
Since the time I've been managing director here at GRDC, I have been looking for opportunities where we can partner with overseas companies and pull new technologies to Australia. In West Australia, there was a conference held. It was the inaugural conference on herbicide resistance, which was held back in 2013. And I was fortunate enough to be able to sit next to Herman Stubler for breakfast, and a casual conversation turned into a much more serious conversation when we actually identified there might be an area of common ground where Bayer and GRDC could work together for the benefit of Australian grain growers.
John, good to talk to you once again on Ground Cover TV.
Always a pleasure.